What did the plate say to the other plate? This one's on me. You can't open your Twitter app these days without reading a tweet from the President of the United States running down the Russia investigation. Cue dramatic reading. The Russia witch hunt hoax, started as the insurance policy long before I even got elected, is very bad for our country. They are entrapping people for misstatements, lies, or unrelated things that took place many years ago. Nothing to do with collusion, a Democrat scam. Quote, Judge Ken Starr, former Solicitor General and Independent Counsel, just stated that after 2 years, quote, there is no evidence or proof of collusion, and further that there is no evidence that there was a campaign financing violation involving the president. Thank you, Judge, at Fox News. And finally, quote, remember, Michael Cohen only became a rat after the FBI did something which was absolutely unthinkable and unheard of until the witch hunt was illegally started. They broke into an attorney's office. Why didn't they break into the DNC to get the server or Crooked's office? Now, all of that was just a single day in December on Twitter for Donald Trump and a Sunday to boot. Now, it doesn't take Sigmund Freud to see that President Donald Trump is totally obsessed with the investigation into Russia's interference in the 2016 election being run by former FBI Director Robert Mueller. Now, whether that obsession is born from genuine frustration with an investigation he believes has nothing to do with him, or a fear that Mueller has already uncovered much and that there's still more to uncover, isn't immediately clear. But here's something we do know. No matter what motivates Trump to talk about Russia, fewer and fewer people actually believe what he says. Here it is. A Wall Street Journal NBC News poll released in mid-December showed that just 34% of people believe that Trump was being honest and truthful about the Russia investigation. More than 6 in 10 said they simply did not believe Trump was being honest about it. That is not an isolated poll either. In a CNN survey released earlier in December, a majority of Americans, 54%, said that most of the things Trump has said publicly about the Russia investigation are false. Just 36% said that Trump's comments and tweets are mostly true. Take a step back. I can't. I'm sitting in a chair. But consider what I just said. A guy who spent a decade running the FBI and who was appointed to that job by one Republican president and one Democratic president is now in charge of a special counsel probe into Russia's active interference in the 2016 presidential election. Now, that investigation has already produced a whole hell of a lot. 192 criminal charges against 36 people and entities. 7 people have pled guilty, and 4 people have been sentenced to jail. Now, the President of the United States, despite all of that, continues to bash the investigation as a witch hunt and a hoax, despite offering absolutely zero evidence to make that case. And this is the really important part, a majority of Americans do not believe the president is telling all of the truth, or even most of it, when it comes to the Mueller investigation. Now, that should be a very big deal. And yet, because this is Donald Trump we're talking about, the idea of how a president should act, up to and including whether they should, you know, tell the truth, seems to have disappeared in Trump's legion of lies. Consider this. The Washington Post fact checker blog counted nearly 6,500 false or misleading statements made by Trump in just his first 649 days in office. That's a rate of 9.9 totally or partially false statements every day Trump has been president, including Sundays. Now, what's even more remarkable, yes, there's something more remarkable, is that the longer he spends as president, the more distortions and lies he piles into each day. During the run-up to the 2018 election, Trump was cresting 60 or 70 falsehoods a day. On a single day in September, Donald Trump said 125 false or misleading things. 125! Now, the sheer pace and quantity of Trump's fibbing, and worse, is simultaneously astonishing and hard to follow. There are just so many mistruths and distortions. And yet, on the most important issue of his presidency, Russia, people seem to be onto Trump. Or at least a majority of them are onto him. They don't believe what he says about the Russia investigation, Mueller, or much of anything else related to the attempts of a foreign country to influence our election. No matter how many times he says, tweets it, which is a good thing. Most people get it. Except, well, these two things. Number one, a lot of people, like somewhere between a third and 40-ish% of the country, don't get it. These are the hardcore Trump base, and they believe whatever he tells them to believe, especially if it includes a shot at the so-called fake news. No matter what Mueller's report on Russia says once it eventually comes out, these people simply will not believe it. No matter how convincing the proof, no matter how much proof, if any, there is, no sale for them. Point number two, the very fact that a majority of Americans think Trump isn't telling the truth about the Russia investigation doesn't mean they view those falsehoods as a deal breaker, it's a deal breaker, ladies, when it comes to voting for him in 2020. Why? Because voters have never believed Trump was honest. Check these numbers out. Just 1 in 3 in the 2016 election said Trump was either honest or trustworthy. But here's the truly jarring thing. Of the 64% of voters who said Trump wasn't honest or trustworthy in 2016, 1 in 5 cast a ballot for him anyway, which suggests that Trump may have devalued truth to the point where people neither expect it from him nor punish him for not adhering to it. And that is the slightly depressing point. We do this every week, twice a week. Check out hot new content every Tuesday and Thursday.